Okay, our training on dihybrid crosses continues, but we've switched to guinea pigs now, and they've got two new traits for us to look at. They're talking about what color is their fur and how long is their fur, and there's a different trait for each of those. So let's get this organized because that's a good habit. Big B in this case means black, which is the dominant color, and little b is white. And that means you big B will be black. Heterozygous will also be black because of the dominance. And little b is how you get a white guinea pig. And then we have, it turns out short stubbly hair is the dominant trait. And then I have to be careful to make my capital and lowercase s's look different. S is a not a good choice for a letter in these problems unless you have good, consistent writing. And little s gives us long, floofy hair. And now, when we cross these, you notice I'm cutting corners here and not doing the phenotypes. I hope that doesn't burn us. They say we have a guinea pig who is homozygous black, meaning big B. That's homozygous black. And heterozygous for short hair. Well, as long as they say heterozygous, I don't need to read anymore. Hetero means one of each. And now we cross this with a white guinea pig. To be white, you have to be little b. And long hair. To be long hair, you have to be little s. Trying to make the little s's very tiny. So there are our two parents, and that probably means it's time for a Punnett graph. Will it be a square? Let's work out the gametes first, and then we'll decide what shape this is going to have. How many different combinations can this parent pass on? If we do it by foiling, here's what comes out. We get first big B, big S. Outside, big B, little s. Inside, big B, big S. And last, big B, little s. What do you notice? We have duplicates here, don't we? We have these two, big, little, and then we got the same combination again. The fact that there are two big Bs means we get two columns that are exactly the same. In other words, we're guaranteed to get a big B. It's just a question of which S will it go with. So we can narrow this down and just say, there we go, that we're going to get big B with big S or big B with little s. Those are the only combinations that can come out of this parent. And this parent is even simpler. How many combinations are there here? There's just one, isn't there? This parent can only pass on a little b and can only pass on a little s, so there's only one sperm cell or egg that they can possibly make, and it'll look like that. So it's a good thing I didn't set up a 4x4 Punnett square here, because really this is just going to be a 2x1. It's going to be a snap. We have two gametes coming out of one parent, which are big B, big S, and big B, little s. And from this other parent, I'll just scoot this over here. Little B, little s is all that they can give. So the guinea pig babies will look like big B, little b, big S, little s, or in this case, big B, little b, little s, little s. What will they look like phenotype-wise? Big B here means black. And big S means short. Short black hair. And here we get big B for black again. And little s means long. So you could do percentages, obviously, and say that's 50% black short versus 50% black long. Or you could say they'll all be black, but 50% short, 50% long. Or if you want to write a ratio, you could say one black short to one black long.